Hi friends, my name is Udara Kasum. Welcome to my ASP.NET Entity Framework CRUD Operation video session. In this video, I am going to continue my last video. Still didn't you watch my previous video? Please watch now. Okay, let's continue. Next, I move to my index folder. Next, I move to my index.cshtml file. Here you can see my existing code, and I want to open my. And here at render section. The scripts required false. Okay, index folder and here at section scripts done. Next, what I want to do, next we want to add my model into the index. Add my project name, my efnetcore.model.user. Well done. I delete my existing code and here I'll do few modifications. Follow me guys. Due class Jambudrum text center. Inside that is three. Use registration form. Be careful. Next, I go to a new class container. Inside my container, I'll go to a to last row. Call in six. Copy that and it. Here I'll go to a form method should be post and action should be go to home controller and copy that, save and update, and here home, save and update. Inside the form tag, I'll go to add my inside the form tag add new class form group. Also, I'll go to some span class. Also, I'll go to a span and ID SPM update ID and get at HTML dot text box. So input type text, we can use input type text instead of HTML dot text box for such as we called HTML helper class. So a lot of HTML helper class in ASP.NET Core, you can use it. I'm going to add text box 4. So HTML helper class is simply we can say HTML helper in MVC work in almost the same way as the server control, as they are used to generate HTML elements which might be needed for links, images and for form elements. These HTML helpers lightweight as they do not contain view states and event model attached to them. Okay, here add lambda exposition and m dot user name, and here I will go to add new attribute such as I want to add class name at class form control. Okay, well done. Let me copy that. Second one is this play name. Display name. And last text box password. We change password and I'll go to a new attribute at type password. Okay, it's look good. And after that, add new class form group float right. Because I want to align my button into the right side, and inside that button class button default cancel exchange clear, right? And next button class button primary, and its name rename as save. Copy that and add update. And go to home controller and copy that update button, and here don't forget to add name because I want to filter update button in my home controller. So here add ID button same. Also add ID button update. Also add ID button clear. And next move to my second column B6. My next column I go to add table. I want to show my user list here at class table. And add ID TBL users, and inside the table add thead, and inside that tr, and inside that th. In my first column I'll go to add edit or delete. Second column th, I want to show my ID, I rename as hash. Next term username, sorry, fourth one display name, and last one password. And after the header tag I'll go to add t body. Inside the t body I'll go to add for each item in model dot users, and here tr, my first td. I want to add two button, edit button and delete button. Here inside add div class button group, button group is same. Inside the button group add button type should be button, and my class button warning update, and here additionally add update class because I want to trigger my update button event and next at danger class, and here change update to delete. Okay, well done. Ooh. Right. Add role group. Okay, well done. Next, move to add my next column TD. At item dot id and go to inside the TD tag and here at data dash field id, copy that and paste. Display name. Display name. First, I need to add username. Right, username. Username. Finally, I show password. Password. Okay, perfect. And what I want to do next. So, okay guys, let's meet with next part. Till then, you take care. Goodbye.